Jesus himself raised the question, what will a man give in exchange for his soul? And the answer to that, according to this world, is anything. Because people are shelling out their soul for trinkets.
He already knows what he's going to do.
ignored his problem. Philip was the kind of guy that always made decisions on everything with a calculator. Amen. He was that way. Philip was the kind of guy that always needed external evidence. You do remember in John 1:46 where he wanted Nathanael to come and see Jesus. You do remember in John 14 and 8 where it was Philip that says, "Show us the Father, and it suffices us." Are you hearing what I'm saying? Philip was the kind of guy that always needed some visible evidence. He had to count first. He had to see it first before he could believe it. And my friends, unfortunately, we got folk like that in this church right now. They worship with a calculator. It's got to all add up first before they can get happy. It's got to all add up first before they can shout. It's got to all, they got to have some evidence before they can do anything for God. I wish somebody here would say amen. It's a good thing that David didn't have a calculator when he was standing before Goliath. Right about it, Goliath was 10 feet tall, with a Goliath weight of 500 pounds. I'm so glad he didn't have a calculator. He didn't count with God. He knew that 1 + God was the majority. What we need to do, some of us, we need to toss our calculators. We need to toss out our calculators and begin to trust in God. Somebody will say amen. Amen. That's the reason why you can't tithe, because you've got a calculator. That means you can't give God what you want to give him because you're counting, but you're counting on the wrong side. You count on your side, but you need to count on his side. If you count on his side, he will get his first and you will get yours last.
Do you remember?